Hi everybody, welcome to day 3. I am in our cozy corner. I hope you watched the classroom tour video. I want you to know that I created this space for you, for us. This is our classroom, not just mine, but our classroom. And I can't wait to have you here someday, whenever that may be. Today's questions are still about getting to know you, but they're a little more specific and a little more reflective. Is that okay? I wanted us to just to think about how this pandemic has affected us. And you may have, or you may be tired of talking about this, but I just want to hear from you. So I have a couple questions. The first one is, what is the biggest challenges that you faced during this pandemic? For me, I'm an extrovert. I love talking to people. I love hugging people. I love seeing all my students, my friends, my family. And I haven't been able to do that this whole pandemic and quarantine time. And I've really missed it, and that was really hard on me. And I had a lot of tough mental days where I just wanted to cry. It was really, really hard. And it still is, because it's new and it's different. The second question I'm asked is, anything positive come out of this quarantine? Anything at all? For me, something positive that came out of this is that I got to know myself a little bit more. And that was really cool. And I found some peace of my own. And that was really special and really cool. And I got to read more, which is one of my favorite things to do. And the last question I have is, any comments, concerns you have about the course, anything you want to say at all. I just wanted to be able to vent and ask anything you need to for that last question. And last thing I want to talk about in this video is this poster up here. This is our classroom mantra. So you'll be the second group of students that I have used this with, and my previous students had memorized it, even had their parents memorize it with them. Because every day when I said good morning to the class, we all said this in unison together out loud. And it's something that became very important to us. So I know it by heart, but if you want to read it out loud with me in this video, please do so if you're in your room or wherever. Here we go. Inner peace begins the moment you choose not to allow another person or event to control your emotions. Well, Miss Hambrook, that's really cool, but what does that mean? Good question. Essentially, it means even if a person says something mean or hurts us, or an event like COVID, for example, we're not going to allow it to control our emotions. Now, it's okay to be reflective and say, hey, this really sucks. This isn't fun. It's okay to acknowledge those things, but it's important to not let it control us, right? Not let it control our emotions, make me lash out in anger at someone that doesn't deserve it, for example. So I'm going to post this in your assignment today so you can look at it and maybe start memorizing it. Something very, very near and dear and special to me, and I hope it helps you as well. I hope you have a great weekend, and I will see you guys on next week. Have a great rest of your day.